second law says, in a closed loop or closed mesh, both meaning is same. Closed loop or closed mesh, algebraic sum of all the potential difference is zero. So this we call loop rule. That's why here closed loop is coming. We are knowing what is the meaning of closed loop. In case of capacitor, we have seen same thing will be applied here also. Whatever we have done in case of capacitor, how we have solved the problem, same way here also. So as potential difference means what? Work done per unit charge. So net work done is zero. That is, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. The non-mole is coming. So energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. That's why we say it is based on law of conservation of energy. So what is the meaning of this one, and when we will say potential difference is positive, when we will say potential difference is negative? So positive and negative potential difference. Suppose there is a resistance and current is flowing in this direction. This is point A, this is point B. So in this case, what will be, if we move from A to B, current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. So this VA minus VB is plus IR. Whereas if you are writing VB minus VA, this will be minus IR. So in a closed loop, sometime we'll go from A to B this side, or sometime we'll move from B to A. So if you are coming from B to A, then this potential difference we have to write minus. Minus IR will be the potential difference. In case of source, suppose this is EMF EG, internal resistance is R. So this internal resistance we will treat in series of this one. So this can be treated as E and this is R, like this. Now suppose current is moving in this way. Current flowing is I. Then what will be VA minus VB? As current is flowing in this way, so what is that? This is higher potential, this is lower potential. So potential difference will be E, which is EMF. Whatever drop is there, that we have considered here. So in this case, what will be? It will be E plus IR. This is the terminal voltage of the source. This is point A, this is point B, and current is passing through this source. Sometime if more than two sources are there, then maybe from one source current is drawn and through one other source current is passed. So in this case, the terminal voltage will become more than EMF. So don't be surprised. Here, current is passing through the source. So in that case, its terminal voltage will become more than EMF. This is always happening in case of, suppose we are charging a battery, in case of inverter battery only, if we are charging. So potential difference of the charger is more than 12 volt, then only it can supply the current to that. So we are supplying the current to the battery of the inverter. So in that case, potential difference across the inverter battery will be more than 12 volt. But when the same source is giving current, the current is drawn from the source.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in book it is given that the potential difference is taken negative when we move in the direction of current. It is taken negative when we move in the direction of current.
We will not follow that. We will follow our concept.
Okay. We don't have to go with the book.
Yeah. Always current flow from potential to potential. So we will use that concept.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Now, in case of EMF, suppose the current is drawn from the source. So in this case, what will be? This can be treated as, this is E, we are considering this R. Here, so in this case, VA minus VB. VA minus VB, what is that? From here to here, this point. This is higher, this is lower. So E. And from here to here, what is happening? We are going against the current. Current is drawing moving from this side. But we are moving from this side. Now suppose this is the part C. So this VA minus VB is VA minus VC plus VC minus VB. VA minus VC, that is E. Now VC minus VB is what? Current is flowing from B to C, so it will be minus IF. So in this case, VA minus VB is E minus IR. Got the point? Yes, especially in these two, any confusion? So when current is passed through the source, when we will write terminal voltage or VA minus VB, then in that case, will be E plus IR. This resistance, we will always assume in series of this cell. You can consider this side or you can consider this side, no problem. Someone can consider, I will not do that way. I will say this side, okay, like this only, no problem. This is your A, this is your B. Current is drawn from the source. So what is this? VA minus VB? From here to here, minus IR plus E. Yes. Till now, any confusion? Well, afterwards, it will not be explained. Simply, we'll write the equation. Yes, anyone having any confusion? So when we are going in the direction of current, what will be? We are moving from higher potential to lower potential. So VA minus VB is positive. When we are moving opposite to the direction of current, we are moving from lower potential to higher potential. VB potential is lower, VA's potential is higher. So VB minus VA will be minus IR. Yes, it is clear till now. So there are different concepts which we can use. Sometimes we say anti-clockwise current, if it is there, then it is positive potential, clockwise current, negative potential. So we are not going to that concept. We will use this concept which we have used in case of capacitor. Same concept we use here also. In case of capacitor also, same thing, loop we have applied. Okay, suppose this is the circuit, the simplest one. So this is E and internal resistance is R. This is R1, this is R2, this is R3, this is R4, this is R5, this is R6. The value of these all are given, suppose. E, R, and these all are given. You may be asked, what is the current passing through this? What is the current passing through this? What is the potential difference at this point and this point? So this type of problem may be asked. So suppose this we are taking. Now, first we'll apply the first law and we will distribute the current. How the current is distributed. And there is only one source, no other source is there. Sometimes two will come, three will come. So we will start from here, okay. So this is positive terminal. This source will always give the current. So current is drawn from this source. Suppose we say, okay, this is I1 current. Now this current will reach here. So while distributing, always keep in mind, whatever current is starting from here, same current must reach here also. If this is I1, this one will be also I1. No other current will enter. Whatever current starts, same current will reach here also. Naturally, here also it will be I1, but there is only one way. Now, when this I1 reach here, what will be? There are two possibilities. Some may go that side, some may come this side. What 5 coulomb charge positive has reached here? Some will say, no, I will not take this shortcut. I have got much time, so I will go that way only. So some will go that side. Some will say, no, I will take shortcut only. So there will be branching of current here. Maybe here, okay, I2, here is I3. Now here, what will be this? There is no other option, this I3 will reach here. I3, this is also I3 only. Because finally it has to come here. There is no other branch here. So what is happening at this junction? I2 and I3 is coming, I1 is coming out. At this junction, what is happening? I1 is coming, I3 and I2 is out. That means this I1 must be equal to I2 plus I3. That is your first law. According to first law. Yes.
So once again, last.
What is happening here? So current starts from here, I1. Now at this point, this junction, two different paths are there. One path is going this way, other path is going this way. Final goal is here only. If 5 coulomb charge has started from here, 5 coulomb charge will reach at this place. So their final goal is here. Some may say, okay, I will take this path. Some may say, okay, I will take this path. Because both are closed only. If it is open, naturally, no current will pass through that. As it is closed path, and resistance is not infinity, means it is not open. So it will, some current will follow this path also. So suppose 5 ampere current is coming here. Naturally, it may be 2 ampere go that side, 3 ampere come this side, or 1 that side, 4 ampere this side, or 0.5 that side, 4.5 this side, whatever it is. So there will be distribution. Now at this place, these two current will join, and finally, the same current. If it is, suppose 4.5, this is 0.5. Then 4.5 is coming, 0.5 is coming, so 5 ampere will start from here. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, if we apply the second law for closed loop, A, B, E, F, A. What will be? What can we write? We have written A, B, E, F, A. So we will start from A to B. What is that? Positive or negative potential difference?
Positive.
Positive potential difference. So it is I1, R1. B to E. That is also positive. I2, R2, E2, F, I1, R3, F2, A. What will be?
E minus I1, R.
Yes. F2, A.
E minus I R, sir, in turn this.
I1 R.
Yes, I1 R.
E minus I1 R, sir, because internal resistance is there.
We are going from this side. So, yes, suppose here is this R you are considering. Then what will be? I1 R is positive, but here is negative potential. This is higher potential. So what will be I1 R minus E equal to 0. Yeah, this is lower, this is higher. Yes. Confusion or what?
Yes, sir.
Sir, once again, you tell how, sir, I1 R minus E.
So here we have taken VB minus BB A. So VB minus VA, what? This is VB minus VC plus VC minus VA. VB minus VC, how much? We are going in the direction of current. So it is IER. Higher potential to lower potential. VB higher potential, C lower potential. As current is in this direction. Now here C to A. What is that? C is lower potential. A is higher potential. A to C, VA minus VC will be plus E. But VC minus VA will be minus E. Yes. Still confusion. This is your higher positive terminal of the battery.
Sir, then earlier one same way you did E minus IR, sir. Same circuit was there.
That was same, sir.
Previous circuit, yeah, same, you may say that that was also exactly same. But you did E minus IR.
This one. Same thing. We have taken VA minus VB. Then VA minus VC plus VC minus VB. VA minus VC is plus E. VC minus VB is minus IR.
Understood, sir.
Yes?
Understood, sir.
Yes. So when we are writing VA minus VF, if you are going in this way, then this is plus E minus IR1. We are going this way. You are free. You can take this way also. No problem. Now, what will be the equation for this closed loop? For closed loop B, C, D, E, B. What will be? B to C. I 3 R 4. C to D. I 3 R 5. D to E. I 3 R 6. E to B. What will be?
Minus I 2 R 3.
Minus I 2 R 2. This is 0. Understood? So when three things are unknown, here I1, I2, I3, three are unknown. So you must get three equations. One equation we got here, other equation we got here, third equation we got here. This directly you can apply here, okay, we will not write like this. This is I3, this we can write I1 minus I3, no problem. Then only two equations will be there, two variables is there, I1 and I3. One this loop will write. Or you can write this whole loop, no problem. But if you are writing this loop and this whole loop, three new equations you will not get. Adding these two loop, whatever you are getting, that will be the equation of this loop. So you are not getting new equation. suppose you are asked find current passing through five ohm and terminal voltage of each cell. So first is the branching of the current. If branching of current will be correct, means 60% chance, means you will get more than 60% mass matching. Because there will be less chance of doing mistake or maybe mathematical mistake you will do. So branching of current correct, loop equation correct, 80% marks. 20% is mathematical mistake, means calculation. There are different ways by which you can do the branching of current. Someone can say, okay, this is 6 volt battery, this is 2 volt battery. Naturally, this will give the current. You are free. You can take, okay, I will take this one I. Here is the current coming. Here it is I1. And this side it may be I minus I1 or I2. If you are taking another equation, you have right. I minus I1 is going that side. So this is I1 coming. This is I minus I1 coming. And this they will join, and here will be again I. This is one way. Another one can say, okay, no, I will not take this one. I will take someone can say, no, I will take from here I1, from here I2, both are the cells, so they are giving current. From here I1 will come, from this side I2 will come. Naturally, this will combine here, I1 and plus I2 will come. Now at this place, what will be? As I2 has started, so naturally I2 will go this side. As here I1 is coming, so naturally I1 will come this side. This is also correct. Final answer of both will be same, whether you are branching this way, whether you are branching this way or any other way. Final answer will be same. Okay, so someone can do by this one branching and someone can do by this one branching and give the final answer. Okay, so suppose this Anmol, you take this branching. Anmol, Ila, and the past two will take this branching. Then Shreyas, Sahana, and Aminav, you take this branching. Because now time will be up. Tomorrow you give the answer. Rest all. Free, you can do any branching. Today, Sabnam is also present. No. Okay, so give the answer tomorrow. What will be the answer of this one? Today we are leaving up to here. Next day we will see the application of this Kirchhoff's law in Wheatstone Bridge. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.